This is our English class. In our last class, what did we learn? Yes, how to keep our room clean, right? Yes, good. Today, we are going to revise the lesson 2. What is the topic? Yes, try to lick your elbow. Try to lick your elbow. What is the meaning of lick? L-I-C-K, lick. Yes, touch with the tongue. To touch with the tongue. Okay. Can you see a boy in this picture? Here is also trying to lick his elbow. But is he able to do it? No, right? Why? Because it is impossible, right? It is impossible to do. This poem, Try to Lick Your Elbow, is written by Ken Nesbitt. This poem, Try to Lick Your Elbow, is written by Ken Nesbitt. And this poem is a funny poem, okay? This poem is a funny poem. And in this poem, we will learn about various body parts, okay? This poem is a funny poem. And this poem is written by Ken Nesbitt. And in this poem, we will learn about various body parts. Now, look at the poem. Your elbow's pretty hard to reach, though it's awfully near. Just try to lick your elbow or to put it in your ear. Your elbow's pretty hard to reach, though it is awfully near. Just try to lick your elbow or to put it in your ear. In this, Ken Nesbitt says that your elbows are very hard to reach. Although they are very near or close to us, just try to lick your elbow or try to put your elbow in your ear. Is it possible to lick your elbow? Or is it possible to put your elbow in your ear? No, right? Yes. So, Ken Nesbitt says that you cannot put your elbow in your ear or you cannot lick your elbow, although it is very near, but it is very tough to reach. Did you understand? Okay. See the new words. Pretty, very, hard, difficult, awfully, very. Next, you cannot reach your elbow with your shoulder or your nose. It's practically impossible to touch it with your toes. You cannot reach your elbow with your shoulder or your nose. It's practically impossible to touch it with your toes. In these lines, Ken Nesbitt says that you cannot reach your elbow with your shoulder or with your nose. It is not possible to touch your elbow with your shoulder or your nose. That can never be done. It is impossible to touch it with your toes also. Okay? You cannot reach your elbow with your shoulder or your nose or your toes. It is not possible. Did you understand? Okay. See the new words. Practically, in real life, impossible, something that can never happen. Practically, in real life, impossible, something that can never happen. Next, your elbows won't go near your neck, your forehead or your eyes. If you could touch it to your spine, I think you would win a prize. Your elbow won't go near your neck, your forehead or your eyes. If you could touch it to your spine, I think you would win a prize. Okay, my dear children, have you ever tried to touch your elbow to your head? Have you? Yes? Are you able to do it? No? Why? Why it is impossible? Yes, because you cannot touch your elbow to your forehead or eyes or neck. The speaker says, if you touch your elbow through your spine, then you would win a prize. Kenneth Smith knows it is impossible to touch. See the new words. Spine, backbone. What is the meaning of spine? Yes, very good. Backbone. Next, I tried to lick my elbow once and I came pretty close. But then I stopped and realized, like, oh no, that's gross. I tried to lick my elbow once and I came pretty close. But then I stopped and realized, like, oh no, that's gross. In this para, Ken Nesbitt mentioned his experience. Okay, once he tried to lick his elbow. When he tried to lick his elbow, he felt that it was pretty close. But suddenly he stopped. Do you know why? No? You know, right? Yes, because he feels that it was, yes, dirty. It was dirty. See the new words? Realize, understood. Gross, dirty. Realize, understood. Gross, dirty. See the rhyming words in the poem? Near, ear. Nose, yes, toes. Eyes, yes, prize. Close, yes, gross. Near, ear. Nose, toes. Eyes, prize. Close, gross. Did you understand? Okay. I told you this poem is about various body parts, right? Yes. Here, see, what are the body parts given here? Yes, eyebrow, eye, teeth, tongue, neck, chest, arm, knee, feet, hair, forehead, ear, nose, cheek, hand, stomach, food. Okay, what are the body parts given in the poem? Yes, first elbow, next, ear, shoulder, nose, toes, neck, Yes, elbow helps the hands to be moved towards and away from the body. It also helps to extend and flex the arm, grasp and reach for objects. What is the use of ear? Yes, ear helps you to hear. Without ears, can you hear? No, right? Yes, ear helps us to hear. What is the use of shoulder? Yes, we use the shoulder for many daily activities, right? Yes, for example, lifting groceries, raking leaves, etc. It also enables us to place our arms and hands in a good position when we are doing different activities. Am I right? Yes. Next, nose. What is the use of nose? Yes, nose helps us to smell and breathe. Can you smell without your nose? No, right? Toes. What is the use of toes? Yes, it helps the human while walking. It gives balance, right? Yes. It also bears the human weight, right? Yes. Next, neck. Neck supports the weight of the head. It is highly flexible. It allows our head to move from side to side. What is the use of forehead? Yes, the muscles of the forehead helps to form facial expressions. Next, eyes. What is the use of eyes? Yes, eyes helps us to see. Eyes helps us to see. Can you see without your eyes? No, right? Yes, eyes helps us to see. Next, spine. It allows you to control your movements. Without a spinal cord, you could not move any part of your body. Now, tell me, what are the body parts mentioned in the poem? Yes, elbow, ear, shoulder, very good, nose, toes, neck, forehead, eyes, spine, very good. So, my dear children, body parts are precious gifts from our God, okay? So, we must keep our body clean. Keeping body clean keeps you healthy and makes you feel good, okay? So, every part of your body must be kept clean. Take a bath every day, comb your hair, brush your teeth every day, then trim your nails, then yes, wash your hands before and after every meal. So, my dear children, you should take care of your body. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.